So what is the solution? You know, because obviously not everyone in the country is a Christian. Obviously in the church and with the gospel, we can help people in terms of racial reconciliation, but how do we do that in the secular world? How does that come about if we don't have CRT and BLM and so on and so forth?
Gosh, I think that's such a good question. And it's really not difficult to answer. I just don't think people like the answer. So I do think that the church is meant to be a light. I do think that we are meant to evangelize. I don't know that there's any hope for culture to have unity or racial reconciliation as outside of Christ. Because in John 17, we read about the unity that's been given to us, the unity that we have through him. And when he prays for our unity, we see what our unity is for. It's so that others would know. Others would believe that God loves them and that God sent him. And so when we look at cultural unity, there's always going to be tribal groups. We are tribal people. There's always going to be people who want to siphon off and who are going to think of someone else better than or worse than themselves, and that they are better than others. This is why the gospel and the scriptures offer us a better hope, because just like you read, we are one.
So it's more like you're saying, it's more like about our sinful, wicked hearts rather than about kind of a racial situation or CRT.
It's always going to be about our sinful hearts.
Yeah. And so I guess my last question to you is, what would you say to pastors and to Christians who are kind of confused? You know, they posted black squares. They don't, the culture is, you know, it's like, I talk about the issue of homosexuality and it's like the culture is so powerful. And what do you say to people, to Christians and also to leaders in the church who don't really know how to navigate this, don't know what to do, and are just kind of at a loss. And so they're just sort of going along with it and they're buying the books, they're buying the, you know, white fragility and all the books. What do you say? What's your advice to them?
Stop going along with culture. Go Amen. Along with the word. The word gives us all that we need for life and godliness. And it's up to us to, one, get into the word and to walk out the word, to disciple people in the word. But I don't have to go to white fragility or Ibram Kendi or Derek Bell or Patricia Hill Collins or anyone else to understand how I live out life in godliness. Nor do I need to go to anyone else to understand the definition of justice. So for Christian leaders, I would say, one, understand the word and get out of sociology. The sociology isn't your main textbook. Yeah. That would be my first, I guess, advice. And then it would be to get bold and know that your voice is meant to be light and hope in this world. Culture is never going to have what Christianity has. Culture is never going to have the hope that we have. But as long as we're looking to culture for our hope, and for wisdom, we're never going to be able to offer them anything anyway.